गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू डू एक्सोजेनेटिक प्रोसेसेस पार्ट टू, दैट इज ज्योग्राफी. ओके, फोर्थ चैप्टर. सो टेक्सचुअल क्वेश्चन आंसर्स वी आर गोइंग टू कंप्लीट टुडे. गुड मॉर्निंग चिल्ड्रन, टुडे आई एम गोइंग टू स्टार्ट लेसन नंबर फोर, दैट इज एक्सोजेनेटिक प्रोसेसेस पार्ट टू. ओके, पार्ट थ्री इज ऑल्सो गिवन, पार्ट फाइव इज गिवन, पार्ट वन एंड टू, थ्री इज गिवन, फाइव इज गिवन, नाउ इट इज फोर. So we are going to do only textual question answers, okay? As you can see in your textbook page number 39, there is no fill in the blanks, but I am going to give you four fill in the blanks, okay? So fill in the blanks number one is, dash is formed due to depositional work of river. So that answer is delta. Delta is formed due to depositional work of river. Second one is, when many flows of water comes together, a dash is formed. Then answer is river. Okay. Third one, the groundwater level sinks down in dash. Answer is summer. Fourth one is, the erosional work of glacier forms dash. Answer is cirques. C-I-R-Q-U-E-S, cirques. Now, see a question. Rewrite the correct sentences, okay? So, first one is, the temperature range helps the wind in its work. So, here what you have to do, you have to rewrite the correct answer, okay? And the question is, I will repeat again the question, the temperature range helps the wind in its work, and the answer is correct. So there is no need to rewrite this sentence because it is already correct. This answer is correct. Okay, you will write correct. Now second one, river's work is more prominent than other agents of erosions in desert regions. Okay, and the answer is incorrect, and you have to rewrite that answer. So answer is, work of wind is more prominent in desert regions than other agents of erosion. Third one is, the work of groundwater is effective in the areas with soft rocks. Answer is correct. Fourth one, the work of wind is not limited like river, glacier or the sea waves and take place everywhere. Answer is again correct. Okay. Now this question number two is, correct and rewrite the incorrect statements. Here same thing it is there. If the statement is incorrect, so you have to correct the statement. Okay. So first question is, the ice on the lateral side of the glacier moves faster than the ice at the base. And the answer is incorrect. So you have to write the correct sentence. The sentence is, the ice on the base of glacier moves faster than the ice on the lateral side. Okay. Question number two, the depositional work by rivers happens because of gentle slope, reduced speed and transported sediments. And the answer is correct. Okay. Now here, river flows at a faster speed than the glacier, and the answer is correct. Last one, the speed of the glacier is more on both the banks than in the middle, and the answer is correct again. Okay, the speed of the glacier is more both the banks than in the middle. Okay, so the answer is correct. Now question number three, here it is, identify the wrong pair. Okay, can you see this? Identify the wrong pair. This one, fourth one, is also wrong. Sorry, it is right. Here, identify the wrong pair. Deposition, V-shaped valley. Second one is transport, ripple marks. Third one is erosion, mushroom rocks. And the wrong pair is deposition, V-shaped valley. And the correct one is erosion, V-shaped valley. Here deposition, instead of deposition you have to write here erosion, erosion. Okay, erosion. Now here identify the name the landforms in the following diagram. So this is V-shaped valley and this is gorge, canyon, delta. So you have to write like this. Okay, now question number 5 is complete the following table by classifying the landforms according to the agents of erosion. So what do you have to do? You have to write here like river, vein, glacier, sea waves, groundwater. Okay, so waterfall is there, so it will come in this box. River, waterfall, where you will write in river. Delta also you will write in river. Pothole also you will write in river. So here you will write in river, you will write waterfall, delta and pothole. In vein you will write, from here you have to choose. So birchens, b-a-r-c-h-a-n-s, mushrooms and rock. Glacier you will write Sarki and Ariti. Okay, sea waves, beach and lagoons. Groundwater you will write sinkholes and pillars. Okay, now question number 6, this one, answer the following questions in brief. Question number 1 is list the landforms that are a result of the erosional work of the river. I will repeat the question. List the landforms that are a result of erosional work of the rivers. Okay, answer is gorge, g-o-r-g-e-s. It is also said caeons, V-shaped valleys and waterfalls are the result of the erosional work of the rivers. Now here number 1 you will write a V-shaped valley. In this point you have to write a V-shaped valley is formed due to the erosional work of river. Okay, and here you can write second point, over a period of time the amount of load, load, in the flow starts increasing. More and more energy of river gets consumed in transporting the material. So here you can write 3 points. Okay, and 3 points you can write. I am giving you 4 points or 5 points in answer. You can write 3 points, 2 to 3 points. As a result, there is less erosion of the bed. The erosion along the banks and the slopes of the valley increases. Hence, the slopes recedes and the valley with near vertical V sides becomes wider, resembling the letter V. Okay. Now, gorge. A gorge is found in the upper course of the river. It is deep and narrow valley with steep sides. What do you have to do, children? What is the question? I will repeat again. List the landforms that are a result of the erosional work of river. Okay. So, what you have to do? You have to write, you have to name the list of the landforms and then you have to write 3-4 points on that. Okay. So, gorge, I said a gorge is found in the upper course of the river. Second point you can write, it is a deep and narrow valley with steep sides. Okay. And in mountainous areas, the river flows with great speed. Therefore, the bed of the river gets eroded more than its bank, giving rise to a gorge that has a steep banks and a narrow bed. Now, third one is waterfall. Waterfall are formed as a result of the erosional work of a river. Second point here, water flowing over a hilly region cascades down a cliff forming a waterfall. In the areas where the hard and soft rocks are next to each other, the soft rocks are eroded faster than the hard ones. A difference in the height along the river beds leads to formation of waterfall. Okay. Now next question is, which agent is responsible for formation of stalactites and stalagmites? And where are they formed? Okay. So answer you have to write. The water of ground. Sorry, answer is the work of groundwater is responsible for the formation of stalactites and stalagmites. Second point, in areas of limestones, the alkaline water seeps through the roofs of the limestone caves. Third one, when this water evaporates, minerals get deposited at the bottom and at the top of the limestone's caves. Fourth one is, this leads to formation of stalactites and stalagmites. Okay, so this is the answer. Question third, list the landforms that are produced by the depositional work of the sea waves. And answer is, the landforms like beaches, sandbars, lagoons are formed due to depositional work of the sea waves. Okay. Now here you have to write point wise. Now here 3 points are there. Number one is beach. Number second is lagoons. And number third is sandbars. So for beach you have to write point A. Large amount of sediments come from the landward side in areas between two adjoining headlands. Here B you have to write, moreover, as these areas are shallow, the velocity of the waves decreases. Okay. Then as a result, the sediments that come from the land as well as those coming from the deep sea get deposited in this area. Okay. So D you will write, predominantly fine sand gets settled along the coast. E you will write, such sandy deposits along the coast are called beaches. Then number second is lagoons. The blackish water separated from the sea water by sand bars and lying in the areas between the coast and bars is called a lagoons. As the water are separated from the open sea, the large waves are not generated. So these lagoons run parallel to the sea coast. Okay, so these are the 3 points. Children, you have to pause and listen, then you write. Because I cannot wait for you, right? I cannot say slowly and I cannot wait for you. As some children has told me that to say slowly. Understood, but it will take time if I will say slowly. Okay, so 2 points I have told you about. One was there, beaches, in that I told you 5 points, and lagoons I told you 3 points. Like first point was, from the blackish water separated from the sea water by sand bars and lying in the areas between the coast and the bars is called a lagoon. Here second point, as the waters are separated from the open sea, large waves are not generated. Third one is, these lagoons run parallel to the coast. Okay. Now third point is sandbars. Sandbars deposited along the sides of the headlands The deposition extends parallel to the coast from one headland to the next. Over a period of time, these deposits extend over long distance, forming bars that protrude in to the water. At some distance away from the beach, these are known as sandbars. Now children, question 4 here, it is name the types of moraines. So answer is, it is there on the page number 32. Okay.